Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.3, Problem 5. This is Section 3.3, Problem number 5. It says, consider the data 41, 22, 37, 104, 68, 91, 8, 24, 63, 17, 51, and 72. Find the five-number summary, find the interquartile range, and draw the box plot. So for the five-number summary, we want to find the smallest data value, Q1, the first quartile, Q2, the second quartile, Q3, the third quartile, and the largest data value. Now, in order to find that, we have to put our list of numbers in order, what they would call ranking the data. So as I look, the only single-digit data value is 8. So let's put that there, cross off the 8. Anything in the teens, I do have a 17. I think that's it. In the 20s, I do have two data values in the 20s, 22 and 24. Then in the 30s, I have 37. In the 40s, I have 41. In the 50s, I have 51. In the 60s, I have 63 and 68. In the 70s, I have 72. In the 80s, I don't have anything. 90s, I have 91. And then I have 104 that's left. And let me just make sure I didn't miss any. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 numbers in the problem. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So that's good. Now, once your data has been put in order or that you've ranked the data, they say, the smallest and the largest data values are very easy to find. 8 is the smallest. 104 is the biggest. So in terms of my five-number summary, smallest data value is 8. Largest data value is 104. Now, for the quartiles, you must find the second quartile first. You can't start by finding Q1, the first quartile. You have to find Q2 first. Q2 is the median, or 50th percentile of the list. Now, I had counted up 12 data values. 12 is even, so the middle of this list occurs between two data values. So if I look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there's 6 that's smaller than this point, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 that's larger than this point. So my midway point between 41 and 51 would be 46. Now, I can see 46 is 5 bigger than the 41, 5 less than the 51, it's in the middle. If you see it easily, that's good. If you don't see it, just take a minute with your calculator even. Do 41 plus 51, divide that by 2. 41 plus 51 is 92. 92 divided by 2, sure enough, is 46. So that's Q2. That's the median. Now find Q1, which is the median of the lower half of the data, not including Q2. So the lower half of the data, not including Q2, are the smaller six numbers, 8, 17, 22, 24, 37, 41. We did not include Q2. Now, to find the median of a list of six data values, again, you have an even amount. The midway point splits position 3 and position 4, which in this case between 22 and 24, which again, I can clearly see right in between 22 and 24 is 23. Again, that you can probably see, but if you don't, just take a minute or two to add the 22 plus the 24, divide the result by 2, you'd have 46 over 2, which sure enough is 23. This one I think is really easy enough to see, but just in case, you do get 23 for Q1. And finally, Q2 is the median of the upper half of the data, not including Q2. So Q3 would be the median of the larger six values, 51, 63, 68, 72, 91, and 104. Again, six data values, six is even, so the midway point falls between position 3 and position 4, between 68 and 72, which again, I feel that I can just look at it and see that it's 70. If you don't, you can just take a minute to do 68 plus 72 divide by 2, which is 140, divide by 2, which is, of course, 70. So that's Q3. So there's our five-number summary. Next, part B, find the interquartile range. The interquartile range is Q3 minus Q1. So for this particular problem, Q3 is 70 minus Q1 is 23. And if I subtract 70 minus 23, I get 47. So that's the interquartile range. And finally, the last part, draw the box plot for my five-number summary here. So again, the box plot for any set of data, you're going to have some type of number scale, and you'll have a box drawn near it with a line in the middle of the box, not necessarily right in the center, but somewhere inside the box, and a line coming out of the top and bottom edge. The line coming out of the bottom goes to a height of the smallest data value. The bottom of the box is Q1. The line inside the box is Q2. The top edge of the box is Q3. And the biggest data value is the line that comes out of the top of the box. Again, these can be drawn side to side, left to right. So the smallest data value would be the furthest right. The what I have as the bottom of the box would be the right edge of the box, etc. So my biggest data value is 104. I'd rather not make 104 little lines. So again, going by tens is a good sensible number scale. So if I put 11 lines, it'll get me up to 110, which is good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And I'll label that 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110. Now, you can draw your box plot in any order you like. I like to draw the top and bottom edges of the box first and build from there. The bottom edge of the box is at a height of Q1. Q1 for this problem is at 23. So I don't have a 23 on my number scale, but by eye, it should be approximately a quarter of the way between 20 and 30. The top of the box is at Q3. Q3 for this problem is 70. I do have a 70 on my number scale. So there's the box. I'll make it wide enough so it looks pretty close to square. Now I'm going to have a line inside the box, not necessarily in the center, maybe right in the center, but anyway, the Q2 is the line inside the box. Q2 is, for this problem, 46. I don't have a 46 exactly, so between 40 and 50 is 45, so figure a tiny bit higher than what you would think 45 would be. Then you have a line coming out of the bottom center of the box going to a height of the smallest data value. So the smallest data value for this problem is 8. I don't have an 8 exactly on my number scale. I have 10. So I'll go a little lower, right under the center of the box, about like that. And then my biggest data value is 104. I also do not have a 104 on my number scale, but 105 would be right between the 100 and the 110. And 104 would be a tiny bit lower. Something like that. And that would be the box plot.